This is possibly the best two sessions in the day. These are people who shape our opinion every day on Indian television. Whenever the anchors allow them to speak, they do speak things that matter to us and to their parties. I also want to acknowledge the presence of somebody, while they regard us in a different way, there's somebody who regards us in a very unique way. I also want to welcome Mr. Sumer Espasricha, who most of us know as Pummy Auntie. So he's there, and I will have the honor of including him in a conversation. Today, and you know, all these three people have a life beyond what they do for their parties and what they do for the country. Mr. Bhatia is a top-notch lawyer. He's a lawyer in the, he's a legal. And one day I met him and I said to him that in the way you speak, you come across as Mr. Arun Jaitley. And he said, that's a big compliment. I don't know if you remember. And so he's a lawyer, legal luminary. Ms. Shazia Ilmi, of course, she's a national spokesperson for the BJP. But she's from the media domain. She was a primetime anchor on Star News. It was called Star News then. So she understands the media world really well. And Mr. Ghanshyam, while he's a spokesperson for the Samajwadi Party, he's an education entrepreneur. He's an edtech entrepreneur. So all three of them, while they serve their parties and serve our country, have multifaceted personalities, if I may say. Now, today's topic of discussion is how important is communication inside the party and outside the party for the parties, for the political parties. So I want to start with a question. Gaurav, if you have a dissenting view on how the communication is being handled, let's say on CAP, on NRC, and it starts right from top, from the number one, number two, if you have a input, feedback, that we could do this a little better, do your political party leaders listen to you and change the tone and tonality?
A very good afternoon to everyone. Thank you, Annuragji, for inviting me here. It's a complete honor. And I would only start by saying, you said that we shape the public discourse, but to all the August gathering and individuals who are sitting here, actually the shaping starts from them. They are the ones who question us, who give us feedback, who tell us what the society thinks, and that is the real pulse that a good spokesperson or a representative from a political party needs to catch and then spread. And as you asked me, I would only say that yes, we are very fortunate to be serving in the BJP for the reason that a spokesperson's job is to finally amplify the view of the party effectively. But when that view is formed, you have to abide by it on the television. That does not mean that a healthy organization like the BJP will not give you room and space to present your own views, to show dissent also, to disagree. But as the Supreme Court has said, dissent is fine, propagation of your view is fine, incitement is not fine, what we see sometimes. So when you presented your view, the senior party leaders take stock of the situation and then they tell you, they fine-tune their party ideology also. But once it has been decided by the party, whether others like it or not, you have to abide by the party line and put it across effectively. And because we are talking about communication, isliye ek line yaad aa rahi hai, main bata dun, what is the power of effective communication? Akele hi chala tha janebe manzil. Akele hi chala tha janebe manzil. Log aate gaye, karwa banta gaya. That is effective communication. If you have the conviction, the right communication will ensure that people are with you fighting for the same cause for the same reason.
Thank you, Gaurav, for being specific and saying, yes, we have dissent, but once there is a view and we've taken a decision, we got to go out and evangelize that. So, I ask you a question now. Now, this CAP and NRC, the communication, how would you rate BJP's communication on that, on 1 on 10? Is it 9, 8, 5? Because there are two viewpoints. You know, on national television, hopefully two, that there are lots of protests that are very peaceful. Whereas yesterday it seemed that only violent protests were happening. I mean, there are some colleagues of mine who didn't show up saying it's bad today, where it's absolutely calm because The families are worried, naturally. So, आप मुझे बताइए कि ये कैप पे और एनआरसी पे बीजेपी की कम्युनिकेशन को आप कितने नंबर देंगे? 10 देंगे, 9 देंगे कि 11 देंगे?
अनुराग जी, it is very important that you communicate. But I'll just give you a small example from what happened in yesterday's debate. You know, it is not only the responsibility of the government to ensure that the right information trickles down.
Ji.
It is also the responsibility of every citizen to know what that person is protesting for. In yesterday's debate, the anchor asked somebody who was opposing the CAA and NRC, that have you read the draft of the NRC? And that gentleman very proudly said, yes, I have read it. So the anchor came to me and I was participating. He said, as the spokesperson of the ruling party, have you read it? I told him, I haven't, because it hasn't been drafted yet. So you know, the point that I want to make is that yes, the party and the government needs to disseminate the right information. You must have seen there have been advertisements in the newspapers. Senior leaders like Narendra Modi ji and Amit Shah ji are using the public medium to ensure the right message goes down. And at the same time, these citizens who come out to protest, it is your right to protest and dissent.
Sure.
But believe me, I know a little bit about constitution. A violent protest is nobody's right.
Of course, we can't.
To pelt stones at people who are wearing, you know, khaki vardi, and then they are trying to serve the nation, is nobody's, you know, right. And therefore, I say, when you communicate, be effective, have the right information, and don't rely on everything that you get over WhatsApp.
So, number kitne denge?
Number main pure 10 mein 10 dunga.
Acha.
But अगर आप बहुत ज्यादा कहेंगे तो मैं 9 दे दूंगा. वो इसलिए कि जिंदगी में एक असूल होता है कि हर चीज बेहतर की जा सकती है. एंड सरकार की बहुत बड़ी जिम्मेदारी है कि अगर आपको लगे कुछ और बेहतर हो सकता है तो इसलिए उसको और बेहतर हम लोग बनाएंगे. ये एक जिम्मेदार सरकार है. ये वो सरकार है जो ऐतिहासिक निर्णय ले रही है. और मैं इतना जरूर जानता हूँ, पूरे आत्मविश्वास से कह सकता हूँ, जब इतिहास लिखा जाएगा तो आर्टिकल 370, ट्रिपल तलाक और CAA और NRC, ये स्वर्णिम अक्षरों में लिखा जाएगा. दिस वुड बी रिकॉर्डेड इन गोल्डन लेटर्स, बिकॉज दीज आर हिस्टोरिकल डिसीजंस दैट रिक्वायर स्पाइन, दैट रिक्वायर्स गट्स एंड कन्विक्शन, विच नरेंद्र मोदी हैज.
थैंक यू गौरव फॉर बीइंग सच अ एलोक्वेंट एंड कन्विंसिंग स्पोक्सपर्सन फॉर द पार्टी. यू आर, एंड आई हैव नोन यू फॉर मेनी इयर्स, बट आई हैव ओनली गॉट टू नो यू इन द लास्ट 10 मंथ्स लिटिल बेटर. And I can tell you that you've become more mature, more pleasant, more toned down. And really, it has increased your reliability, dare I say, as an external. So it's a welcome change. I don't agree with you that the BJP should get 9 on 10 on the communication, on the tonality. But we'll come to that.
I respect your right to disagree.
That's okay. I wish you could tell that to my wife, but that's another story. Coming to Shazia. Shazia has been a friend. I met her 15 years back. So I've known her for a while, and I've seen her, how she has evolved. And I can tell you that she's a very sensitive person, if I may use. So Shazia ji, I would like you to be as real as you can be today. I know we have two spokespersons from the BJP. But you're also, I don't want to give you a religion, so to say, but sure. You meet your friends from the Muslim community, and I'll be
doing it.
And they have real apprehensions. And some of the messaging and some of the comments have been from the top political leaders have been very aggressive. The tonality has been very aggressive. It hasn't been a dialogue. It has been like, we're handing you down something. Take it and don't ask too many questions. Sorry, that's the tonality. I'm not saying that CAB is right, wrong, NRC. That's another story. But I'm saying, what is your view, both as the party spokesperson, as a woman, as a citizen, and as a Muslim who lives in India, on how much do you agree with what's happening, and how much would you give to the communication in terms of 1 to 10?
So first of all, Annurag ji, thank you so much, and thank you for your candor and your honesty. Thank you, Exchange for Media, for actually having these wonderful interventions and forum where we can have a healthy and informed debate where everything gets said. and people are allowed to disagree without any confrontation or ugliness. So thank you. We need many more of these. So I really want to congratulate Exchange for Media for this exercise that they have been taking for years. You know, I've been an anchor. I've been an activist right there with this Anna Hazare Andolan or Nirbhaya. And yes, I'm in politics now, active politics now. I am a spokesperson. I'm a panelist. And what is happening now is extremely disturbing and distressing. If I can give a more of a Picasso's 360 or a cubist point of view from a communicator, from a spokesperson, from being an Indian citizen and a Muslim citizen and a woman citizen, so to speak, I would say that a lot more needs to be desired where communication and correct communication and communication with responsibility is concerned from all sides. Whether it's the opposition, whether it's the party, whether it's genuine misgivings, whether they're apprehensions, whether they're fears of some of our brothers and sisters, they have to be addressed. As it is important for my government and my party to come clean and explain as to what is meant by CAB. Similarly, it is an equal responsibility of the opposition, of every teacher, of every professional, of every protester to know what they are up against. So I think honesty and objectivity can never be sacrificed at the altar of politics, at the altar of ideology. That is one sacrifice I will never make in my life. I never have compromised and never will.
Should we read more into this?
No, please do not read any more into it. This is it. There is such a short attention span and there is such a need to jump at everything that is being said that nothing can get said with depth and gravitas. And with seriousness. Let's play with this thought. What are we doing today? I mean, you know, one day we are all up with the protesters because of whatever's happening and we are blaming the police. Next day, all of us feel very bad because a policeman is being beaten up and is being ambushed. Look at us as a society and our reactions. I think we have to take stock of who we are. Let's cease to be, Hindus and Muslims and men and women and BJP and Congress. But see, what are we doing to ourselves, our acumen, our intelligence as a society? So I feel the protests and the whatever the breakdown of law and order that I see is a huge failure on our own individual intelligence, politics or non-politics aside. So I'm making a bigger point here, Anuragji, I hope you're getting that. And yes, it is the duty of my party. And like I have said, CAA has nothing to do with any Indian whatsoever, Muslims and Hindus alike. So it doesn't impact Gaurav Bhatia, it doesn't impact Ghanshyam, it doesn't impact Annurag, it does not affect Shazia Ilmi and many, many crores of Muslims. Similarly, NRC, the draft of which has not been made, the notification of which has not been done, is a thought only because every country, can you think of any country in the world where there is no register of citizens? Can you imagine, going to the US without a visa? Or people being curious about whether this person is a citizen or not, or any country for that matter. Somebody was telling me about Europe. I mean, so it's important for us to know census-wise and registration-wise about a documentation.
But Aadhaar pe na thodi.
But I would add a rider. To be fair, there are genuine misgivings. There are genuine apprehensions. People have been calling up. My khalas and my mamus have been calling me up. So yes, when you talk about the Muslim.
क्या का पार्टी चेंज कर लो
देयर्स अ लॉट ऑफ प्रेशर बिकॉज़ दे सो एंड देयर्स अ एंड दे आर वेरी सीरियस एंड सीनियर मुस्लिम लीडर्स एकेडेमिशियंस हु हैव बीन कॉलिंग मी एंड सेइंग शाजिया व्हाट इज हैपनिंग एंड आई एम जस्ट सेइंग आई विल डू व्हाट आई विल डू प्लीज डू नॉट जंप द गन प्लीज रीड टेक स्टॉक स्लीप ओवर इट एंड देन एटलीस्ट नो व्हाट यू आर अप अगेंस्ट मोर ऑफन देन नॉट वी आर सो रेडी टू बिलीव एंड समटाइम्स परसेप्शन
is bigger than reality.
With reality.
Of course.
So
always.
Right now, this is what's happening. So it's just shadow boxing.
Of course.
We don't even know what we are fighting.
Of course.
Let's push, come to shove. You know, we'll go get there. So I would just like to make an appeal to all. Get out of this prism of ideology about this self-imposed hatred for one and love for the other. Maybe because in keeping with your interest for Muslim citizens, you might be working against them.
Okay, Shazia, let me ask you this question.
You all claim to be himaitis of Muslim. हो सकता है मुसलमानों का ही नुकसान कर रहे हैं उनको इस तरह से डरा धमका के क्योंकि हो सकता है उस डर का कोई लेना देना है ही नहीं इस बिल से. तो आप जिसकी बात कर रहे हैं, जिसके आप हिमायती बनने का आप एक वो जता रहे हैं कि आप हिमायती और रहनुमा हैं, हो सकता है आप उसी कौम का सबसे ज्यादा नुकसान कर रहे हैं.
सो शाजिया, लेट मी आस्क यू टू स्पेसिफिक टू दिस कम्युनिकेशन कॉन्फ्रेंस, व्हाट कुड हैव बीन डन बेटर इन कम्युनिकेशन. सेकंड, इज देयर अ सर्टेन टीजी फॉर दिस, फॉर होम दिस कम्युनिकेशन इज वर्किंग. देयर इज अ सर्टेन टीजी दैट द बीजेपी रीचेस आउट टू. फॉर देम इट मे बी परफेक्ट, यू नो, इट मे बी वर्किंग विद देम, राइट. So I want to ask you, what could have been done better in the communication? Is there something?
You know, with CAA, CAB and now CAA, we've seen what happened in the parliament. We saw the Home Minister categorically spell out, and the Prime Minister later, that has nothing to do with Indian citizens. Now people are protesting. People are protesting against this perceived notion that CAA and NRC coupled together will make a difference. But the NRC draft is also not out yet. So even if you have genuine misgivings, and maybe there is a whole lot of misinformation and disinformation,
and of course the opposition is
fuming, and a build up, you know, project Modi ji is anti-Muslims, see is becoming a Hindu Rashtra, and you know, so maybe sometimes this entirely biased propaganda gets the better of us. All I'm saying is, until you see the draft, you don't know it. CAA has nothing to do with you and me. And what is being said in the CA has been said by Manmohan Singh.
The creative artist agency in LA. CA is the creative artist agency in LA. Of course, I am not an actor, so it would never apply to me.
But we could do with some humor. Thank you, Annurag.
Yeah, really bad PJs. But Mr. Tiwari, coming to you, she didn't answer my question directly about what could be different on communication. Now, Mr. Modi has gone outside the country, protected the country really well. This is also in some way harming India's image abroad. And the Democrats are very upset with Mr. Modi for endorsing Donald Trump. And whether it's on the Kashmir issue or on this issue, the Democrats are, you know, using this to hammer us, you know. Really, I mean, that's a reality. What are your views first? If in your party you have a different view and you communicate it to the party, does it get factored in the communication? And second, what would you do differently if you were to take CAA and this whole initiative to the people? What would you do different in kind of communication, tonality, content?
Well, thank you so much, Annurag, and thank you everyone for giving me the audience. I think there are many things that can be said, but some things stand out. One, the Prime Minister saying from a stage that you can look at the protesters by their clothes. I don't know anyone misunderstands what the Prime Minister meant. Second, government in the face of protest releases a document on ANI, which is a FAQ on CAA, NRC, unsigned, released by sources, unnamed. Third, that not a single minister in this government said why students were attacked in a library, girls were harmed, people's hands are blown. Delhi police, in the face of videos, is unable to accept who fired at the students and why. Fourth, the entire CAA, NRC, the moment anybody says that CAA has nothing to do with us and then speaks of NRC in a different chapter as if it is unrelated, is a miscommunication, assuming that people don't read. It is the Home Minister who, from April 11, 2019, till this date, and even yesterday, the acting president of BJP spoke about NRC, in the face of their own allies, the chief minister saying that we will not implement NRC, in the face of a federal system that is buckling, in their own allies, in states where they have their own governments, to say that people will not read CAA and NRC together is assuming that your communication will fly in the face of mass protest. Practically, what has happened in this country is, it is not the opposition that has led the charge against this establishment, which has fanned fears. It is people from university. What was the Home Minister's response of students protesting? My alma mater, IMB, protested. They left their chappals outside the gate because they were not allowed outside the gate. Students at IMA protested. What was the Home Minister? These are premier institutions of the country. The Home Minister's response was that only 22 universities in the country are protesting. 22 institutions of 240 universities in the country. These are our premier institutions. Students are protesting at Harvard, in London. Yes, you can ignore all that protest saying that, yes, there is something called a massive sole proprietorship of nationalism that we decide when it gets hurt and when it doesn't get hurt. But the reality is the world is writing. All of us have grown up proud on the values of Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina. So if something fires in the face of who we are as a country, the values we hold so dear as thought leadership in the world, then it is the responsibility of the government to respond to it. But I have seen minister after minister struggle in television interviews in front of friendly cameras to say what NRC documents are likely to
possibly be. Some of the ministers are not for it.
Let me complete. How can a government, after spending crores and crores on Aadhaar, standing in Supreme Court saying that everything from your telephone number to your income tax document to your bank accounts have to be linked in Aadhaar, stand up and say we don't know whether Aadhaar is a necessary document for NRC?
I think that's one statement in front of
demonetization like style, where there'll be zero accountability and every one of us would have to prove. At a time when people are struggling for better education, jobs, a livelihood, the economy has tanked, we want every citizen to stand up in queue and prove that they are citizens of this country. So I think the communication is completely unaccountable and irresponsible. It has fanned fears. People don't want to look at those fears because for a long time, the government has gotten used to riding communication piggybacking on communication on the back of a friendly media that obliged from print to
television. Wadi media.
And that is currently backfiring because it is not the opposition that is leading the charge. It is people who are reading and responding, and the government is unable to respond because there are only two people who can respond. One responds without a discourse, and one responds with a discourse but with selective anchors.
Okay. Gaurav wants to respond. Clearly, your voice at least resonates in this room and predictably. As a lot of people would call these protests elitist, even then.
The beauty of democracy is you preach what you are not doing, because I know of political parties who have not been sending their spokespersons for a meaningful dialogue for 6 months. And this has got nothing to do with him. But I'm just letting you know.
You know, my team was very worried that both of you are on the same panel. I said, no, it's okay. They'll do okay.
Absolutely.
They were very worried.
So, I look at it differently. I would again, talk about Article 370 and how it was amended in Article 35A. I think the preparation was so good, communication was so good, that a historic decision was taken and Kashmir was fully integrated with our country. And I'm sure the audience here knows that Article 370 in the Constitution was a temporary provision. But for 70 years, no elected government had the courage to actually remove it. So Modi ji ensured that it is done. And in a democracy, we may disagree. I will again say, and I don't want to make it political, He was talking about the Home Minister, the Prime Minister. I think we do it every day for 4 hours on television. The audience here is for something where we can agree to disagree and then also agree on the core issues which affect our lives. And that is why we are sitting here. So I will like to, place the bigger point here. In a democracy, Parliament represents the will of the people. If the CAA is passed by the Parliament, and in Parliament you have discussions, you deliberate, but ultimately, if there is majority, a bill is passed, it turns into an act. Can an elected chief minister after that say that I will not implement this law? And this very chief minister has actually taken oath under the constitution, Anurag ji, that I will protect the spirit of the constitution. I think there will be complete anarchy, chaos, if we stop respecting our institutions, which have proven their ability to keep the nation together. My second point. Nobody would tell you, and I would again request, maybe Ghanshyam ji can answer this. Can anybody tell me, for Indian Muslim citizens, is the CAA taking away any right?
No.
Second, if they say, Hamara Samvidhan khatre mein hai, to hame bataiye na, ki Samvidhan ka kaun sa pravadhan, kaun sa anuched aisa hai, jo violate hua hai. Aur iske saath main aapko ek udharan deta hoon. अभी एक प्रोटेस्ट चल रही थी, मैंने देखा 16 साल के बच्चे अनुराग जी वहां चिल्ला रहे हैं, अरे हिंदुस्तान जिंदाबाद, हम खतरे में हैं, हम खतरे में हैं. तो एक चैनल का रिपोर्टर गया, उसने कहा आप बताइए प्रोटेस्ट किस बात का है. उसने कहा सुरक्षा का, सुरक्षा का. दूसरा बोला भैया किसका है, कहता है सुरक्षा का, तो पत्रकार ने पूछा क्या देश की सुरक्षा का, तो उस बच्चे को कुछ नहीं पता था, वो वहां से मुंह उसने छुपाया और दूसरे के पास चला गया, और रिपोर्टर ने कहा किसकी सुरक्षा का।
यू सेइंग दिस इज स्टेज
रिपोर्टर। मैं अभी एक लाइन में आपको बताता हूँ क्या है। तो उसने कहा सुरक्षा का है, मेरी सुरक्षा का, कहता नहीं। तो रिपोर्टर ने बोला आज जो प्रदर्शन हो रहा है वो राहुल गांधी की सुरक्षा का हो रहा है। तो जो बच्चे प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे थे उनको ये नहीं पता था कि क्या प्रोटेस्ट है, लेकिन आपने बुलाया, 25 लोगों को खड़ा कराया और वो नारे लगा रहे हैं। तो फिर से मैं कहूंगा, अगर सर्वोच्च न्यायालय सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज नाउ सीज्ड विद द मैटर, व्हाटएवर द सुप्रीम कोर्ट डिसाइड इज फाइनल, एंड आफ्टर दैट वी नीड टू एक्सेप्ट द वर्डिक्ट। बट फियर मॉन्गरिंग, सेलेक्टिव रीडिंग ऑफ स्टैट्यूट्स विदाउट इवन रीडिंग, आई थिंक इफ यू स्टार्ट प्रोटेस्टिंग एंड अपोजिंग द डेमोक्रेटिक प्रोसेस ऑफ आवर कंट्री, it doesn't augur well for our democracy.
Fantastic. Because the communication conference, a quick comment.
Just to add to that, you know, I have every right to protest and express my protest, even if I have a genuine misgiving at about what NRC could be in future, which has so far not been drafted or notified. I can have imaginary illusions about CAA, and I can just perceive myself to be under danger. So I have every right to protest even then, even if I am having hallucinations.
Of course.
I have every right to. But I do not have a right at all to create a riot, to break public property, to indulge in vandalism, and to interfere with someone else's right to peace, to livelihood, and to transport and communication.
I don't
what
think
we saw yesterday happened.
Disagreement on
yeah.
that.
I have been there, you see, and I know how these protests work, and the part of me is disgusted, and I realized what how naive I was when I was part of the Nazare movement, and what we were saying and what we were doing and what we are doing. So I in fact have evolved in that sense, and I take back, because the serial protest every time breaks the fabric. And look at educational institutes, the least we can do is for students to do well in the exams, to concentrate there and to protest against whatever is happening, but not in this unpeaceful manner. What Delhi police did and the excesses have to be condemned. There has to be action, and nobody can take that away. It sure. is absolutely wrong. But to beat up policemen, to throw a to khadedo them like you saw happen in Lucknow and Ahmedabad, is a very bad sight. It says a lot about us as a people, then as political parties.
Thank you, Shazia ji, for saying. Tiwari ji, I want to ask you very specific, because we are a communication, I don't want to be broad, I want to be narrow. See, you take Donald Trump got impeached, I mean, in one house, the other house they don't have. But he's in the last 3 to 4 weeks used that as an advantage in communication, painting himself as a martyr, you know, as a victim, as a witch hunt against him, because he has the people's mandate and the Democrats are kind of not accepting him. And it's become very personal, whether it's similarly here, of course, the BJP has a constitutional majority, so on and so forth. But there is a 30, 35, 40% of the population which is not voted, which is a large population for the BJP. And Pradhan Mantri ki baat le, unhone bola, hum sabko saath leke chalenge. Hum sabko, to wo sabko. They are turning communication, which is seemingly negative on them, as an advantage with their core constituency. We know there is a certain constituency which likes all this, which is very anti-Muslim, dare I say, which is, right? So tell me, is there something to learn for a communicator from whatever is happening?
So I believe that communication is as much listening as it is speaking. And what is clear in this particular scenario, it's ministers, right, are still saying CAA and NRC in two different tones. It was not people of India who demanded NRC street by street. It was the home minister of the country who went rally after rally from April 11 to speak about NRC. To say ki we will hum ghuspaithiyon ko nikalenge, sharnathiyon ko. Now our grandfather's document is supposed to decide whether we are asylum seekers or ghuspaithiya or citizens. And did anybody ask if the home minister from April 11 rally to till this date has not been able to articulate where does Aadhaar stand in the face of NRC?
That one comment I would say NRC did create confusion.
Stand in the face of NRC document. Then why was he talking about NRC? Why should the home minister of this country fan fears?
Theek.
right? Coming to the point of communication is as much about listening. What has happened clearly in this particular case is the opposition was in debate with the government, but the opposition became weak. As a result, this debate bypassed opposition in a big way beyond what happened in the parliament.
Fair point.
So the raw political narrative of NRC, which was purely divisive and fear-mongering, reached the people directly. And as a result, people are reacting, and as a result, the government is not able to respond because government knows fully well how to respond to opposition. They know fully well how to invent leaders in opposition and respond. So the listening part, my final point on this is, I think politics is becoming, whether it is in Donald Trump's case in the US or in India, when the Prime Minister of India was communicating a message of hope in the run-up to 2014, the country rallied behind him because there is a communication of direct to voter in hope. There's a different communication that happens, unsaid communication that happens when it comes to fear. What we see right now is that unsaid communication, but eventually politics will become B2C in my opinion, direct to the voter, direct to the citizen. And in that, people who can communicate clearly and also listen what the citizen is saying that, look, no, I can't fool you by saying CAA in one chapter and NRC in another chapter and not connecting the two, even though you know it is connected, I know it is connected, everybody knows it is connected, people are fearful, but I choose to nuance it.
Read Santosh Desai's column in Times of India called A Problem for All Solutions. He echoes the view you are saying. I just, you know, yesterday I was watching Navika's interview. I left at about 9:40 from the hall with the Home Minister, and she asked a very simple but yet deep. He said, Amit Shah ji, ye bataiye ki kabhi bipartisan politics, dialogue, agreement wali politics hogi jo pehle shayad 20 saal pehle, 25 saal pehle thi. Abhi har cheez pe vibhajan hai. There's no convergence of views. There's no agreed way forward. This is our way and we are moving forward. And she asked this very brave question to the Home Minister. And of course he replied. I wouldn't say that it was a very convincing reply, but he did make an attempt and he did try to explain. So I just want to close by asking and then bring the audience, really we want to keep to our time. What are your through rules of communication that you follow when you go to a TV debate, when you come to an event like this? I know you can't take away your BJP hat, it's an important hat. You believe in its ideology and what it's doing. And I want to ask you a pointed question. And is the RSS for us? Whether you comment, is the RSS for what's happening in terms of CAA and NRC? In the top three people in the RSS, are they happy?
See, two, three things. First of all, when you say that when you go as a spokesperson and you have multiple hats, I'll tell you something. When I represent my party, I also represent as a lawyer. So whatever I say, ensure that it is legally and constitutionally right. It is towing the party line. And third and most important, I speak as a citizen.
Sure.
You know, party line is very, very important, but my party has taught me to be sensitive to the needs of the citizen.
Gee.
And yes, you make a very relevant point when it comes to communication and having a dialogue inter se between the party. Why is it that the opposition today is reduced to shouting slogans, coming to the bin of the house, or, you know, taking out faults in the bill that is to be tabled? What about having a constructive approach,
sure,
making five suggestions how we can improve the legislation that is to be built or tabled? So the point is, I would wait for a day. Narendra Modi ji is a communicator par excellence. We have seen Man Ki Baat. We have seen how he comes on all important occasions and he addresses the nation. But why does the opposition shy away from just reaching out and saying that we want a discussion on this? These are our constructive suggestions. Please either convince us or you get convinced. I think that should be the beauty of democracy, that you have a dialogue and then, you know, agree to some issues.
In 2020, will the Prime Minister give a press conference?
See, I will answer that as well. How you communicate? Press conference is not the only means by which you communicate.
Of course not.
Every leading channel in the run-up to the 2019 elections got interviews from the Prime Minister and very lengthy ones. It was an hour, 1.5 hours.
Two friendly channels.
Just two friendly channels. You know, I think you are degrading the media by calling them.
No,
friendly
it is a reality.
Just bear me up. You know, I would only say that, you know, this is another problem, Annurag ji, with respect, that today if two BJP spokespersons are sitting here and one, you know, from the opposition, you are biased. If the media is asking you a tough question, you say the anchor is biased. If Narendra Modi ji is giving interviews to certain channels, you say they are all friendly channels. And what about Amit Shah ji? You know, doing press conferences, giving interviews.
I think I was very impressed in the way he engaged with Navika.
So the point is only this. In a democracy, communication is the key. But somebody would use the social media effectively. Somebody would give interviews. Somebody would communicate through rallies. Somebody would have round tables with 200 people in a hall. As long as you are accessible, you are voicing an opinion, and you are also, you know, taking opinion of the common man, I think you are communicating. And that is the essence of communication.
Good. We'll open it. We'll take 2-3 questions from it. We're running a little late, but I'm just... Yeah, so quick one question. Khurshid, aap ek question puchhe. Aur kisi ka koi question hai? Royal, aap chhodiye. Nahi to main ek hi... Annurag, aap... Quickly, bol dijiye, aap sun rahe hain. Chetan, we need mics for people. You're not a loud Punjabi from Delhi. Otherwise, you won't need a mic. You're from Patna, right?
Gaurav ji, aapne badi achhi baat boli. Aap ki hamare Pradhan Mantri पिछले बार गए जनता से बातें किए क्या कल जनता से बात करेंगे वो टीवी के द्वारा देश बिखर रहा है
इसके लिए कह रहे हैं
देश बिखर रहा है लोग बच्चे मर रहे हैं तो जब वोट मांग सकते हैं टीवी पर आके तो आके बातें करें
नहीं आई अंडरस्टैंड योर क्वेश्चन द ओनली थिंग आई वांट अ क्लेरिफिकेशन आप किसके लिए पूछ रहे हैं
जी
मोदी जी के लिए कह रहे हैं प्रधानमंत्री जी के
जी 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 मैं उनको मानता हूँ अपना यहाँ का सरपरस्त
बिल्कुल अच्छी बात है आप भी भारत के नागरिक हैं उन्हीं को मानना चाहिए
मैं मान रहा हूँ सर मैं मेरा नाम खुशी अहमद है सर
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल
मुझे बहुत सारे जज्बे भी हैं भाइयों के प्रेम भी है लेकिन बगल में बैठी हुई इल्मी जी मैं उनसे भी बोलूंगा भी एक सवाल मेरा सवाल ये है कि क्या हमारे बच्चे जो मर रहे हैं यहाँ के यंग बच्चे क्यों वो तो आपके बच्चे हैं आप गार्जियन घर
के
जब आप वोट दे मांग सकते हैं
देना चाहूंगा
जो यूनिवर्सिटी में मरे
एक
जामिया में
मैं एक मिनट मैं आपसे बिल्कुल सहमत हूँ कि अगर किसी भी बच्चे को चोट लगे मरना तो बहुत ही दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण है तो दर्द हमें भी होता है और एक अनुराग जी ने बात कही कि एक कोर कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी वोटर्स की बीजेपी की है आई डिसएग्री विद दैट फॉर द रीजन आई टेल यू जब तक चुनाव नहीं हुए सब अपनी अपनी पार्टी के लिए वोट करते हैं लेकिन जब देश का प्रधानमंत्री चुन लिया जाता है तो वो हर नागरिक का जो है प्रधानमंत्री है चाहे वोटर ने उसके लिए वोट किया है या नहीं किया उसकी जान की हिफाजत हो उसको एजुकेशन हेल्थ मिले उसका प्रोटेक्शन हो ये सुनिश्चित करने की जिम्मेदारी चुनी हुई सरकारों की होती है सर आपने कहा प्रधानमंत्री जी कम्युनिकेट करेंगे कि नहीं तो मैं आपको एक बात बता दूं देखिए प्रधानमंत्री जी ने सबसे पहले अपील करी जितने भी इस तरह के सेंसिटिव मामले आए हैं और इस मामले भी उन्होंने खुद ये आश्वस्त किया क्योंकि झारखंड में चुनाव चल रहे हैं कि कोई भी मुस्लिम भाई बहन ऐसा नहीं होगा जिसका हक छीना तो दूर की बात है कम भी हो और अमित शाह जी गृह मंत्री हैं और ये गृह मंत्रालय का मामला है आप खुद भी मानेंगे उन्होंने भी कई अपील करी है तो कम्युनिकेशन गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से न्यूज़पेपर में एड्स देना प्रवक्ता है पार्टी लीडर्स हैं हम लोग सब लोग कम्युनिकेट कर रहे हैं और एक बड़ी बात मैं आपसे कहता हूं कि ये बात जान लीजिए कि जितनी ये ड्यूटी प्रधानमंत्री की है गृह मंत्री की है या रूलिंग पार्टी के प्रवक्ता की है उतनी ही जिम्मेदारी हर नागरिक की है कि CAA NRC जैसा अभी दोबारा आया जो ड्राफ्ट नहीं आया उस पर चर्चा हो रही है ड्राफ्ट किस फॉर्म में आएगा उसका इंतजार तो करिए सुझाव तो दीजिए कि कैसे बेहतर हो सकता है
इन फेवर ऑफ व्हाट मिस्टर भाटिया से समटाइम्स वी हैव वी प्रीजज द इशू इन दिस केस दैट मे व्हाइल देयर आर रियल इश्यूज दैट मे आल्सो बी हैपनिंग
सर आई एम नॉट कन्विंस सर मेरा कहना यह है सिर्फ छोटा सा बात
I will sit with you, have a cup of tea, maybe you can convince me. That is the beauty of democracy.
One on one.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Well, okay, we'll let this lady ask. I don't know her. Rohit and Annurag, I know, so no questions of people I know.
Hi. I just want to ask, the protest is being seen as a student protest. Yes, it started as a student protest. बट हम लोग बहुत ज़्यादा बच्चों की बात नहीं कर रहे हैं शायद अब अगर पिछले ek do din ya rather 3 din se dekha jaye to the protest has moved away from being just a student protest and the average citizen has come on the streets to join them. How is that being communicated or not being communicated correctly?
So you say the protest is becoming larger than just a university phenomena and a student phenomena.
I was coming here and before that I was watching a news channel.
Which one?
I'll tell you something, the beauty of being a spokesperson is that your fingers are never at rest. You keep on switching channels to see which channel is covering what. But see, it's good if you want to protest, you want to show dissent, and maybe, yes, there might be citizens who are concerned apart from students who are protesting. But please also understand that a vast majority of the country is happy with all these reforms that are taking place. And today they are not out in the streets, so they cannot be counted. But their voice, their opinion is equally important as those who are protesting. And as long as the protest is, you know, non-violent, the protest doesn't hurt other citizens, you don't create inconvenience for a person, for a brother or a son who's carrying his father or a brother to the hospital and you stop the ambulance. I think in a democracy, that shows a lot about the essence of democracy and the strength of our democracy.
Fantastic. We'll end this. I think we have, no, we'll, please.
He didn't respond to my question.
He's a spokesperson of our party. He's the spokesperson of our party.
I know. And the
protest
and the ma'am.
Have
not been
violent.
Okay.
Ma'am, that's what I think we agree there, that as long as the protest is non-violent, it is all fine. But since we have this habit of watching television, just yesterday, a cop was being beaten and he was running for cover. We have seen what happened. I belong to Lucknow, what happened in Lucknow. So we are one when we talk about peaceful protest. But then there is, you know, no agreement when it comes to pelting stones at the army in Kashmir.
It's a communication conference.
So
it's
that
not a conference on CAA.
Is the disconnect here.
Yeah, it's a communication conference. It's not a CAA conference. That we do another day. I just want one last comment from both of you, Mr. Tiwari. Is there an spokesperson you admire outside your party? And why?
Well, I can say
no, you can't name Arnab Goswami. He's not a spokesperson in our party. But he's a very close friend of mine.
I think we are a strong democracy because there are a lot of people who have, with good facts and without
who?
Temper,
so who?
Without temper, shaped public discourse. Abhishek Manu Singhvi, for example, in Congress, has done it.
BJP mein koi hai?
Late Arun Jaitley ji used to do it. Late Sushma Swaraj ji used to do it. I think one thing that I can say as a spokesperson and having been a spokesperson for Samajwadi Party for many years, it's a legacy built by Gaurav. Never ever have my national president called me and said that why did you articulate this issue in this manner? So there is an element of you as a person taking all your knowledge, all your ethos to television.
Sure.
Part of your job is to inform people and build a discourse in a gradual way. And as I said, as much listen. And I think we are fortunate, as a young politician, I'm fortunate that a lot of people have been able to do that in parliament, outside, building an informed debate without pushing for an instant public opinion on a certain manner.
Thank you. Mr. Tiwari, Mr. Bhatia, I asked you this at INBA in February. Is there a spokesperson apart from Mr. Tiwari that you admire?
My friend Ghanshyam was also part of the panel then, and you know, he's now taken the answer that I had given in that conclave.
Yes, I remember.
Because I named Abhishek Manu Singhvi ji.
And Arun Jaitley ji.
But I must say that, you know, the individual is definitely important. Some of them are great speakers. But every panelist who comes, if you follow the panelist and the spokesperson, you would learn that they have some individual traits and qualities which are very unique, and there is a lot to learn from that person.
Give us some, one name. One.
I'll give you. Like, you know, my colleague, Sudhanshu Trivedi ji, I would say.
Bahut badhiya, mereko bhi.
And why do I say Sudhanshu ji? I'll tell you that, you know, everybody has a unique style, but I've seen that Sudhanshu ji, गुस्सा हो के भी गुस्सा नहीं दिखते हैं
हाँ, नहीं, वो संबित पत्रा जी से दिखते हैं
नहीं Okay. Sambit again is a great, you know, spokesperson. And also there are many in the Congress.
I think he may give competition to Sumer. I mean, he's really sometimes funny. Huh? He makes a smile in a good way.
Dekhiye, that is what I'm saying. Some people like to put forward their point aggressively. Yes,
Sudhanshu is clearly very
Sudhanshu
good.
Ji is very, very balanced. Good. Somebody very likes good. To add some humor. But the point is how effectively, since today's conclave is on communication, how effectively you are communicating that it reaches the mind, the heart and the soul of the listener.
Thank you. Please give a big round of applause to Mr. Bhatia and Mr. Tiwari.